Hello everyone, hope you guys are all doing well and staying safe. If you are new here, welcome, my name is Rana. Today I wanted to share with you guys some of the planner trends that I have been absolutely loving. So if that sounds like something that you would be interested in seeing, I hope that you would consider sticking around and subscribing. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so the first planner trend that I wanted to share with you guys are transparent journaling cards. Now, these ones over here are from Cloth and Paper. They are in the black foil. This says minimalism and this says j'adore. Okay, so the new thing that we are seeing now with the transparent journaling cards is the white foil like these ones over here. These are from Sequins and Paper. I actually just got these in today and I'm absolutely loving them. This one says, if you can dream it, you can do it. And then this is, you know, a whole bunch of affirmations, which I absolutely love. This says grit and, you know, defines it for you. So I really, really love the white foil, especially against the chocolate brown in my planner. I think it looks really nice. So again, you know, you can put your transparent journaling cards in a credit card holder like I have done here in the back. You can also clip them in your planner like I did here in the front. And this one over here says pretty things inside, which I've added to my front pocket. So again, they come in different colors, different, you know, pictures and quotes and things like that on them. So really loving this trend, and I can't wait to see what, you know, planner shops will come out with starting next year. Okay, so the second planner trend that I really love is these Tombow brush pen markers. Now, these started to become really popular, I want to say in 2019, but they are definitely still around. It's become more popular now. I know when I go through my Instagram feed, I pretty much see everybody using these, especially in the minimal planner community. So again, these are the Tombow water-based. These seem to be the popular ones, especially this one over here, which is 942. It's sort of like a tan color. They are double-ended. Okay, so you've got the brush marker on one end, and you have the fine tip on the other end. Okay, so again, you know, they are being used as highlighters. As you can see, I do use them in my weekly spread, and I have mentioned this before, but if you wanted to avoid any smearing, I would suggest that you highlight first and then write down, you know, whatever it is that you wanted to write on there, so that that way you can avoid having your pen smear. I can't wait to see if these will continue to be really popular in 2021. Okay, the third planner trend that we've been seeing, especially over the past few months, I want to say, are these round sticky notes. So these ones over here are from Cloth and Paper. They're in the mint color. These ones here are from Poi and Hun, and they are marble. So what I love about these is that, you know, they're different. They're not your typical, you know, squared sticky notes, even though I absolutely love square, don't get me wrong. But I love the fact that these are different. The way that, you know, I use them is sometimes I layer them just like this. So you can have like a reminder here, an appointment on this one. You know, you can use them as tabs in your planner as well. So, you know, to highlight anything that's important maybe on that page. So then it just looks like a tab. So they're very versatile. They come in, you know, a lot of different colors and things like that. So again, the third planner trend that I'm absolutely loving right now is the circle sticky notes. The fourth planner trend that I'm loving right now is anything transparent. So the transparent page flags are really popular right now. All the planner shops are selling them. They come in so many different colors. These ones here are from Cloth and Paper. I also have these ones here that are from Planner Press, and I do have a discount code, which I'll link for you guys in the description box below. And again, like I said, there are a lot of other shops that do sell transparent page flags. Now we are starting to see some transparent square flags and transparent sticky notes. So that is also really popular right now in the planner community. One thing to keep in mind though is that you can't just use any pen to write on them. Some of the pens do smear. So I know that some people use a Sharpie pen to write on them. Cloth and Paper also has, I believe it's called a Uni pin marker or something. I'll link it for you guys in the description box below, which you can also use to write on them. But I really do love the fact that they are so thin, which is really nice, so they don't bulk up your planner. So the way that I have been using these is as a tab. So again, if I wanted to bring my attention to that specific page, then I can use it as a tab. You can also, highlight something. So let's say I wanted to highlight this appointment over here. So I can just put the page flag over there. And then I know that that's something important. Or, you can use it to as a reminder. Let's say, there's something happening tomorrow. For example, I have a tire appointment. Okay, so then I would just write myself a reminder to put the winter tires in my trunk. Page flags are very versatile. They do come in different colors, different sizes, different shapes. And again, I love the fact that they don't bulk up your planner, which is really nice. So that is the fourth trend that I'm absolutely loving. So the fifth trend that I'm seeing a lot more of these days are DIY planner dashboards using Canva. People are, being creative, which I absolutely love. It reminds me of, back in the day when we used to make our own dividers, our own dashboards and things like that. So, you can print your dashboards on vellum, you can print them on printer paper. So again, it allows people to be very creative. I wish I was that creative, but I'm not. So I definitely do love seeing what other people come out with. I love seeing all the creativity in the planner community. The final planner trend that I wanted to talk about today are Moterm planners. Now, at first, Moterm planners just kind of seemed like any other planners. I couldn't really understand, all the rage with the Moterm planners until I saw the Croc Moterm planners. They are absolutely gorgeous, and I know that, they are not very expensive, which is really nice. The only, downfall with the Moterm planners is that they do take a while to ship. I know I've heard some people say they've taken 2 months until they've gotten their planner, but to be honest with you, at that price and, the way the Croc looks, I think it's definitely worth the wait. And you never know, it could be a planner that I might add into my lineup in 2021. So we'll see what happens. So those are all the planner trends that I have absolutely been loving. Let me know in the comment section below, what are some of the planner trends that you guys are liking right now? And I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Until next time, take care, guys. Bye-bye.